Hi Poodles, Richard Ryder here with Queer Comics, and this week's topic is Canadian showbiz. Now, that's a relative term. I mean, there are a lot of people that work in Canadian showbiz, they just don't work on Canadian projects, or there's a lot of Canadians in showbiz, they're just not doing it in Canada. So, I thought it would be a good idea if I went and talked to some Canadian celebrities. This might take a while to find them. Marcy Rogers, Paul Bellini, Sexy Wexy, Marilla, hi. Ted Morris, playwright, actress, bon vivant, working actress, and also now crew member on Rain, Canadian comic. I want to hear what you have to say about Canadian celebrity and entertainment. Canadian celebrity, Marcy, what do you got to say about it?
Well, I guess I'm going to say again, what celebrity?
Yeah.
Well, there is none.
Canadian celebrity, Marilla. What do you think? What do you got to say? I got to pee, stop.
I don't know if I'm the right person to talk about Canadian.
Because of your pretentious fake accent?
Well, and myself, I think a lot of it has to do with the whole question of Canadian identity. I mean, basically, to me, Canadian identity has always been, how are we not American?
Right.
You go to L.A., you take a dump, and then you come back and you're a hero in Canada.
Yeah. Or, how are we British?
Right, right. We'd be lovely and
British. Oh,
wouldn't you love it? A little bit of bangers and mash before the ha-ha, darling.
I've worked 45 years to perfect this pretentious fake accent.
It's delicious.
I think it's pretty good.
You're really good.
Thank you.
You know, for the longest time, Richard, I thought it was because there was no star system. Mm-hmm. We don't have gossip mags. Mm-hmm. We don't have any kind of infrastructure. They rarely throw down a red carpet. But I'm starting to think it's our unions. I hate to say it, but actor gets in the way of a lot of small production. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And they don't seem to distinguish between a big show with American funding and a tiny little webisode.
You can't really forge a career here.
No.
No,
you can work, but you won't have a career.
Yeah.
The fault could be with our broadcasters. Mm-hmm. They have no imagination. They're not willing to take risks.
In Canada, nobody puts down their own money. Nobody's Aaron Spelling it. They're all getting grants and
Canadian
funding.
Tire money.
Yeah, your money.
I brought them empty.
How hard are you going to work if it's not your money on the line? Do you know who I blame?
Who?
The Beachcombers. They set the bar low. They set it low.
Unfortunately, for me, it was the trouble with Tracy. Oh. I saw that show and that kind of killed Canadian television for me.
We did watch something on TV Ontario because we're very...
You were in the country and you only got the one channel?
I was tied to a chair.
Scene Things used to be good.
Yeah.
There was a show about a social worker situation that was with Lolly Cadeau that was good.
Yeah.
But
Hanging In, Lolly Cadeau was in that one. Yeah, that was it.
But
I was on that show.
Okay.
Nobody recognizes me. My dress had green hair.
Well,
I had hair. Let's just say hair.
Kids in the Hall is the only thing. And am I allowed to say is still the only thing that I think massively funny that came out of Canada?
Yeah. The first year Kids in the Hall didn't even run in my own hometown. Can you imagine? And that's Canada
God,
in
Timmons?
A nutshell.
What else did they Shania Twain wasn't even helping them out there.
The CBC affiliate in Timmins did not run the show in its first year.
Do you think it's our own fault, their lack of Canadian celebrity?
Yeah, I think it's the whole Canadian politeness.
I did a show yesterday and I was partially paid in some continuing education.
They gave you $50 and a coupon?
They're like,
And humility?
Yeah. I dressed up like a foam jug of weed killer to pay the rent.
You did a skin job?
How do you mean?
Yeah, that's what we call them in England, when you dress up and promote, you dress up as the product. That's a skin job. You did a skin job.
I did.
How do you feel?
Dirty and my rent got paid. My rent got paid.
Copy that.
Yeah, I didn't suck a dick.
Wow, shit just got real. Boom.
Look at my chin.
Look at my chin.
Oh my God, Richard.
This is why we're not more famous.
Our chins should have agents.
Mine does. You didn't get one. It's not a good agent. It's a Canadian agent.
It's a
Canadian. Let's not lie.
Agent, so it's not work. Your chin isn't getting any work.
Oh, it's getting work. It's just not good work. It's all webisodes.
It's all webisodes.
We have our stars that are starting to get international acclaim. Sarah Polley is a director. Her films are getting...
Yes.
Mary Walsh's Hatching, Matching, and Dispatching was, I think, the best piece of Canadian television, and it didn't survive a season.
Every First Nations show I've ever seen on TV, North of 60, Rez...
Excellent. The writing's brilliant.
Yeah, brilliant. The acting's brilliant. Mm-hmm. Brilliant.
I mean, it's not like we don't have talented people.
No.
It's just that we don't have enough people here to sustain an interesting industry. That,
I think we would all be more famous if we had more people going, ooh, look who that is.
I never think of Bryan Adams. Let me tell you. Ever.
Why, when we do a film, if it's not Anna Green Gables, nobody gives a flying fuck?
I see lots of Canadian films, and I do like a lot of them. I think there's some great directors in this country.
My big thing, I want to write a novel. Because I'm really quite introverted, and I prefer just really writing. Mm-hmm. So, but I am only sending it to the States, because there's no point in... No. I mean, I'm published here, but there's no point in attempting to get a writing career in Canada.
Why are you, fabulous British girl that you are, working and living in Canada? You're avoiding the law? What happened?
I married a Canadian.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you know?
I thought he was American. My bad. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, you missed the mark.
I could have had
a career in New York or LA, and look at you in Toronto, working crew.
And I understand why people flee from Canada. I have to admit, my husband and I were thinking of fleeing from Canada because we both have the right prerequisites to become extraordinary aliens in the States. Mm. And then I booked the TV show, so we postponed that. But we
So it's you. You're ruining your chances. Would you move to another country to become more prolific in your stand-up career?
Yes.
Ooh la la.
If you can work in France, do it. But not for long, because the cheese is full fat. Yeah, I'd like you to go to Britain, too. Would you defer to an American show over a Canadian show if you had a choice on TV?
Always.
And how about a British show?
Always.
Would you see a Canadian movie over an American movie?
Well, we support American junk.
Yeah, because it's fantastic. Now, are you more famous in America than you are in Canada?
Probably.
Yeah. Nobody cares if anyone wins a Juno or a Gemini.
There is no more Genies or Geminis. No. They're the Canadian Screen Awards.
It sounds more American.
Doesn't it, though? Mm.
Son of a bitch. Oh, wow. There you go. Canadian celebrity from the mouths of Canadian celebrities. You may have known some of them. You probably don't. That's how you know they're Canadian celebrities.